Hi, my name is Betty Daisy, and I am a resident here in North Delta since 1985. We moved from Prince George to this area. Before that, I was a Langley citizen and moved there from Saskatchewan in about 1948 and lived on farms most of the time until I moved to Prince George. My story today is going to be about glass milk bottles that were used for home delivery in the early years. The bottle itself has quite a story it can tell if you followed the bottle around the milk route. My dad was a milkman, so I am the milkman's daughter, and I have been on the route with him a number of times and seen the different things that happen. My brother, who lives in Langley now, his name is Jim McGregor, and he wrote this poem about my dad and being on the truck in one of those early morning times. It goes, clip-clop, clip-clop, the rhythm starts with the horse's feet. Creak-rattle, creak-rattle, wagon wheels pick up the beat. Jingle-jangle, jingle-jangle, harnesses chimes with horses' hitches move. Clinking, tingling, clinking, tingling, bottles keeping time with hooves. Dogs barking, roosters crowing, morning birds are singing sweet. Milkman whistle, sleepers stirring, the song of an early morning street.
Does this ever bring back memories of when I was a kid?
And this milk bottle brings back a lot of memories.
In the wintertime, when he would leave these bottles on the doorstep,
it used to freeze.
The little cardboard on the top would not be on the top of the bottle, it would be up a couple of inches.
And the cap would, as he brought it in the house, it would start running all over or whatever. But it was literally rising above the top of the bottle.
There were four kids in the family. And we used to run out, if Mom didn't get there first, break off the cream, and it was like having ice cream. It was delicious. The lecture was worth it because, well, you take the cream off of the milk, you wind up with skim milk on the bottom. Who wants that? Oh my gosh.
The milk bottles, we always had to make sure that they were clean before we put them out. I can remember my mom putting the money in the milk bottle and sitting it out on the front porch so that when the milkman came with his horse and wagon, he had the milk bottles and the money, and he would just exchange them for the filled up milk bottles. It was kind of neat.
Mom always left a note for the milkman as to what she wanted, like 2 quarts of milk and a pint of cream or something.
People would leave notes in the bottle for my dad, and they would leave their change in the bottle if they were buying milk. So it was very interesting because some people washed their bottles and some people didn't. And so when you had to dump out the bottle and the change came out and it was covered in sour milk or whatever, it was very interesting. Or if the note was all rolled up and stuck in the top of the bottle, sometimes it fell to the bottom of the bottle and you had to go in there and pry it and get the note out of the bottle to see what they wanted. Early milk bottles were about the 1860s. They were invented in the United States actually and Britain and brought up here. But in the early days, there were no milk bottles as such. People used, when you went out on the milk, you had a ladle that was the size of a pint bottle or a quart bottle, and you would ladle the milk from a large tin pail into whatever container the people offered you at the door. So it could be a beer bottle, it could be an old soup can, whatever they had, you would dump the milk into and go back to the dairy. But when the milk bottles were introduced, they were then brought out to the people, and they came in various sizes. There's a pint bottles, half pint bottles, quart bottles. gallon jugs. There were all forms and sizes of milk bottles. Those bottles had to be loaded up in the morning on the trucks, fresh milk. Milk was only a day or two old at the very most when you first got milk delivery. And the bottles would be loaded onto the trucks and sent out. My dad started his home delivery services in Ontario, and when he was around the age of 21 or 22, he moved to Ontario from Saskatchewan and went to work for his aunt in a dairy called Rutherford Dairies in Ontario. He would get up in the morning, and he didn't have a truck, he had a horse. So he would get up very, very early in the morning, go to the dairy, get the horse ready, load all the bottles onto the truck, cover them with sacks to keep them warm in the winter and wet sacks to keep them cool in the summer. Off he would go on his route, and he knew most of his customers and what size they would like to have delivered at their door. When he would go on his route, he told me that it was very, very quiet in the morning, and all you could hear were the milk bottles clanging against the metal containers that they were carried in. So it would be very, very quiet except for that noise. That was like an alarm clock for a lot of the people in the different areas, because they would hear the trucks and they would know what time it was because the trucks would be out there. His horses also knew that when they were going out, it was going to be a long day. So they would very slowly walk up the street. My dad would walk beside them. They would stop where they needed to, and away they would go. But as they turned that last corner on their way home, the horses knew that the stable and the feed and the water was very close by, and they would take off, and my dad would basically run the rest of the route down the hills or wherever he was going to get that horse and buggy and all the bottles back. They would pick up empty bottles at each house and put them back in the trucks and take them back. The bottles then had to be unloaded. They had to be taken into the dairy where they were washed and refilled for the next morning and ready for the trucks to go. My dad also worked in a number of dairies in the Lower Mainland. He worked for Seal Cap Dairy, he worked for Hillside Dairy, he worked for Dairyland. And in all those years of his work delivering milk, I think he missed 4 days of work in all those years and he retired when he was 65. He was in very fit condition because of all his running beside the horses or delivering the milk. It was interesting because in the wintertime, he would leave a little later in the morning because it was dark and he didn't have to keep the milk as cold. Going out in the summertime, he left very early, 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning, so that he could get out before the heat would come, because the milk in the bottles would sour if you left it on the doorstep too long, and people would complain the next day that their milk was sour. Milk bottles came with funny tops on them as well. And the very first milk bottles that came out had wooden stoppers in them. They were actually put into the top of the bottle. After that, they found that the wood was not holding up, so they put metal stoppers in the top of the bottle. And then they moved from metal stoppers to wire around the top of the bottle to keep the lids on. And then in the last years, and mostly what I remember about home delivery are these caps that were just little cardboard tops on them. Some of them, the first ones didn't have this little pull tab. You had to have a special tool to pull it out. These ones you could just pull out, and that was. Bottle caps, like you said, they changed. They also started color coding the bottle caps so that you would know what the people wanted. You could just grab it out of your basket and go. They also had little coupons, or tokens they called them, with the dairy name on it and what it was. So the color, this particular dairy had yellow for 2% milk, and this one was for standard milk. Red was for standard. Different dairies had different colors. These ones were originally from Seal Cap Dairy, and they were squares or rectangles so that they would know what they wanted, like a pint of milk or a quart of milk. You would know what the people wanted. They also, when my dad delivered in One of his roots for Dairyland was in White Rock, and you would carry a metal basket at that time. There was metal baskets carried with all it, and you would load it up with pints, quarts, half pints, chocolate milk, put a few things in it. But most of the time he knew what his customers wanted. But as he got to the top of the stairs, 23, 24, 25 stairs sometimes, at the top of White Rock, a customer would look in his basket and say to him, "Oh, I really wanted a quart of chocolate milk today, not just a pint." So he would have to walk down the stairs. Well, he wisened up very quickly and learned to bring a basket halfway up the stairs and hide it so the customer couldn't see it. And then he was able to go down and get whatever size bottle of milk they wanted to purchase. So he was a wise milkman. I was very fortunate at times to be able to ride on the milk truck with my dad. In those days, there weren't rules and regulations that through workman's compensation or whatever that said you couldn't be on the truck. So I would get up very early in the morning and head out with my dad, and it was a very quiet time of day. It truly was a time just to contemplate and think about things, because my dad was not a talker. He would live by example, and so you would follow his example. He had a book that he called his root book, and every customer was listed in there, their likes, their dislikes, what they wanted, what they might ask for. And all you had to do was look at that book, jump off the truck, deliver the milk, grab the bottles, and head back to the truck. We had great times together, although the day was long for me. He put in most days 12-hour days, but he was way better in shape than I was in those days, I think, and I was young. So riding with him on those trucks, also they would carry large, because the trucks at first were not refrigerated, so the trucks would have large blocks of ice. And sometimes we would get kids running up to the truck, and he would chip off a piece of ice and give it to the kids. Sometimes he had small bottles, because there were bottles that were, I believe they were called a third of a pint, and they were made specially for school children. And occasionally he would have some of those bottles that he would give out to those kids if they came by. He would give them a bottle of milk to share. Also, the other cats would follow us in the morning. And so he had some milk that he would, had a saucer, and he would put, take a bottle of milk that maybe was starting to sour or wasn't quite as good, or he couldn't, wasn't quite full enough, and he would pour it into a dish, and while he delivered in that area, the cats would have their morning milk. So it was great to be with him and do those spend those special times with him. My brothers also spent time with my dad on the truck occasionally, although he told them that he didn't think they would ever be milkmen, because they weren't quite quick enough to jump in and out of that truck and get going.